sorry about that brief news. Yeah. Shit looks appealing.
Ten years ago.
Ah, a history lesson?
Jack saw his first shoe puff here. Surprised, he drew his blade and struck it.
Why?
He was drunk. Thought it was a fiend.
Oh, brother.
We offered all the money we had as an apology. Jekt never drank again. But it would seem that Shoe Puff still works here.
Bad idea, yes.
Please, we beg of you.
Impossible, impossible.
What's wrong?
This guy won't let our chocobo on the shoe puff.
Ah, it is kind of big.
It's just not fair.
He does have a point.
Chocobo's lives matter.
So what? We just leave him behind?
Hey, I didn't say that. Just.
It is no good. We will have to find another way. We will find a ford where we can cross on foot. Yes, Captain Sir.
But that'll take days.
Where there's a will, there's a way.
Oh, boy.
Not leaving Buddy behind.
That's our captain.
Where there's a will, there's a way. Those words stayed with me. I wonder how Captain Lucille is doing.
Would you like to hear a bit about the wondrous shoe puff? Pity. Would you like to hear a bit about the wondrous? Very well. There are many things we do not know about the shoe puff. For example, what does it eat? It eats nothing. The water it sucks through its schnoz somehow supports its considerable size. Some theorize it eats teeny-weeny waterborne organisms. And that, as they say, is that.
Driver, know when you're ready.
Riding a sh.
How little you know. Some things little boys never grow out of.
right?
Alright, before we hit the shoe club, we can, here, no time. Shit. This is accidental. See, this is... thing I ever put that in there. It's a good team. One.
Oh. Here we go. I bought all that stuff, I can't. Thank you.
City.
A machina city, 1,000 years old. They built the city on top of bridges across a river.
But the weight of the city caused the bridges to collapse, and it all sank to the bottom.
Right, it's a good lesson.
A lesson?
Yeah. Why build a city over a river, yeah?
Well, it would be convenient with all that water there.
Nope, that's not why. They just wanted to prove they could defy the laws of nature.
I'm not so sure about that.
Yevon has taught us. When humans have power, they seek to use it. If you don't stop them, they go too far, yeah?
Yeah, but don't you use machina too? Like the stadium and stuff, right?
Yevon. It decides which machina we may use and which we may not.
So what kind of machina may we not use, then?
Remember Operation Meehan? That kind.
Or war will rage again.
War?
More than 1,000 years ago, mankind waged war using machina to kill.
They kept building more and more powerful machina.
They made weapons so powerful, it was thought they could destroy the entire world.
The people feared that Spira would be destroyed.
But the war did not stop.
What happened then?
Sin came, and it destroyed the cities and their machina.
The war ended, and our reward was sin.
So, sin's our punishment for letting things get out of hand, eh?
Man, that's rough.
Yeah, it is.
But it's not like the machina are bad.
Only as bad as their users.
It's because of people like the Albed screwing everything up.
What could that be?
Sit down.
Sorry!
The Albed!
Bruh, they got the girl.
Luna, we'll save you.
Everybody else dying.
Thank you.
Are you hurt? No, I'm fine.
Gah! Those out bed!
Is everybody okay?
I'm sorry, we're all okay now.
Yuna.
Super full speed ahead!
Damn the out bed! What do they want from us? Could it have something to do with Luca? What are they after Yuna for? Wait, they're mad they lost the tournament. Oh, wait, they're mad about Operation Mihen.
I wonder, didn't Kamari's clansmen say something about summoners disappearing?
So the Albedo behind that? Those sandblastic grease monkeys.
Hey, Waka. It's no use complaining about the owl bed. We'll protect Yuna from anyone, anywhere. It's that easy. That's all I need to know.
Well, I guess so.
You're right.
Yeah?
Looks like we're stuck here for a while.
Yo, Yuna, let go. I'm gonna find something to do.
Waka, at your service. Thank you.
sieht jetzt. Oh, okay, okay. The one.
You're
the
not
only.
Dead?
Back there.
Ah! Riku! You're Riku! Hey! You're okay! How you been?
Terrible.
Yeah, you don't look so good. What happened?
You beat me up, remember?
Huh? Oh, that Machina? That was you?
Oh, that really hurt, you know. You big meanie.
Wait, but you attacked us.
Nuh-uh, it's not exactly what you think.
Yo! Friend of yours.
And you can say that.
Pleased to meet ya. I'm Riku.
Yuna? Lulu? I told you about her, remember? She was the one who helped me before I was washed up on Besaid. She's an Alba.
Wow, so you like all your life. What luck meeting here, huh?
Praise be to Yevon.
So, Riku, you look a little beat up. You okay?
Waka.
Huh? What?
There's something we need to discuss.
Oh, go ahead.
Girls only. Boys, please wait over there.
Right. Sorry, Waka.
Huh? What?
To be my guardian.
Show me your face.
Huh?
Look at me.
Oh, okay.
Open your eyes. As I thought.
No good?
Are you certain?
100%. So, anyway, can I?
If Yuna wishes it.
Yes, I do.
Now we got 100 of them, motherfuckers.
Riku's a good girl. She got me a bunch.
Mm-hmm.
Squad.
Well, I'm for it. The more the merrier.
Righto. Then I'll just have to be the merriest.
It was strange. Even though Waka had always hated the Albed.
Riku, at your service.
He never realized Riku was one of them.
Damn it. You're not doing that to me, right? You're not. You're not. You gave me Orin with light. You're not.
Treasure chest. wonder what's inside. I just got on you. You'll be sorry. Any better?
Just watch.
No problem. Ha! Oh yeah.
This ends now. Farewell.
And watch. Yeah. Take that. I'm good, yeah?
Guado salami, boys.
We have been expecting you, Lady Yuna. Welcome to Guado Salam. This way, m'lady. This way.
Me?
Whoa, whoa, whoa!
Oh, I beg your pardon. I am called Trommel Guado. I am in the direct service of our leader, the great Seymour Guado. Lord Seymour has very important business with Lady Yuna.
Business with me? Whatever could it be, I wonder?
Please, come inside the manor. All will be explained. Of course, your friends are also welcome.
Twist our arms, why don't you? Ah, I almost forgot.
Wait.
seems that Maester Seymour, he's young.
Tell you, they ripping off the pilgrims. They listen, you, me, you can trust. More than a guado. Thank you.
Yeet.
These are the past leaders of the Guado.
They all look the same.
Maester Seymour doesn't look like them, no.
Don't you know? The last leader, Maester Jiskel, wed a human woman. She was Seymour's mother.
Oh.
Stay close to you.
I wonder what smells so nice.
Why does he...
Kimari.
He wants to give you his baby.
I don't like the smell of this one, eh?
This way, please. I will go inform Lord Seymour. Please wait here. I get the feeling he called us.
There's no temple here in Guadasalam, see? Summoners usually just pass through on their way elsewhere. What?
I didn't even ask a question and you're explaining things.
You'd rather I...
No, no. Maybe you finally believe I don't know anything about Spira. And maybe that means you believe me about Xanarkin, too?
Well, there are many things I do not know. Your Xanarkand is one of those things. I suppose I can't say what I think, either way. Still, be careful. You shouldn't tell other people.
Yeah, I know.
Stay on your guard.
Why? This guy is just a priest, right?
Those with power use that power. Maesters have power.
Wait. You sure you don't have something against Yevon?
I lived a long time in Xanarkand.
Ah.
Kimari, speak no more.
This is good.
What could it be?
Truly, it is good to have guests again. Since Lord Jiskel passed away, these halls have been too quiet.
The death of Lord Jiskel was a great loss for all of Spira.
Was this Maester Jiskel really such a great guy?
He brought the teachings of Yevon to the Guado. He was truly a great man.
Truly a loss for us all. Now, a new leader, Lord Seymour, has come before us. Lord Seymour is the child of a Guado and a human.
He will be the tie that binds our two races together. But that is not all, I think. Lord Seymour, he will surely become the shining star that lights the way for all the peoples of Spira.
That is enough trouble. Must I always endure such praise? Welcome!
You wanted to see me?
Please, make yourselves at home. There's no rush.
Please keep this short. Yuna must rush.
Pardon me. It has been a long time since I had guests. Lady Yuna, this way. This sphere is a reconstruction created from the thoughts of the dead that wander the far.
Xanarkand?
Correct. Xanarkand, as it looked 1,000 years ago. The great and wondrous Machina city, Xanarkand. She once lived in this metropolis.
She who? Lady Unalesca!
She was the first person to defeat Sin and save the world from its ravages. And you have inherited her name.
It was my father who named me.
Lord Braska was entrusting you with a great task. He wanted you to face Sin as Lady Unalesca did. However, Lady Unalesca did not save the world alone. To defeat the undefeatable Sin, it took an unbreakable bond of love, of the kind that binds two hearts for eternity.
Wow, your face is beet red.
You okay?
He asked me to marry him.
You serious? Hey!
You know what Yuna must do?
Of course. Lady Yuna. No, all summoners are charged with bringing peace to Spira. But this means more than just defeating Sin. She must ease the suffering of all Spira. She must be a leader for the people. I proposed to Lady Yuna as a maester of Yevon.
Spira is no playhouse. A moment's diversion may amuse an audience, but it changes nothing.
Even so, the actors must play their parts. There's no need to answer right away. Please, think it over.
We will do so then. We leave.
Lady Yuna, I await your favorable reply. Why are you still here, sir? I beg your pardon. We Guado are keen to the scent of the Far Plane.
Yuna, the High Summoner's daughter. Seymour, the leader of the Guado. Married in the name of Yevon, overcoming the barriers of race. It would give Spira something cheery to talk about for a change.
Sounds just like a passing daydream, like Auron says.
Come on, let's just get on with the pilgrimage. I mean, marriage?
Jealous?
What? No way! We gotta defeat Sin. Romance can wait.
You sure picked a fine time to lay this one on us.
Maybe it is a fine time.
You serious?
If my getting married would help Spira, if it would make people happy, if I could do that for people, maybe I should do what I can. I never imagined doing anything like this, but I won't answer till I know what's right.
Seriously?
You could always just quit your pilgrimage and get married.
I will. Go on. I'm sure that Lord Seymour will understand.
I guess so.
I am a summoner. I must fight and defeat Sin.
Like Braska before you.
I had to stop myself from shouting. What's there to think about?
I'm going to the far plane. I'm going to see my father and think on this.
Go on. We'll be right behind you.
Mm. I wondered why none of the others ever asked Yuna. Do you love Seymour? Do you even like him?
Word. Word, word, word.
Question about this far plane. When somebody dies, a summoner sends them to the far plane, right? So their souls, or whatever they are, they go to the far plane, right? But that's the far plane we're going to, right? And Yuna's old man's there too? Do dead people live there or something?
You thinking those funny thoughts again, yeah? You'll see once we get there.
Aren't you coming?
I do not belong there.
You're scared.
Searching the past to find the future. This is all that is there. I need it not. You'd better be going.
You're not really going to see the dead. More like your memories of them. People think of their relatives, and the Pyreflies react to them. They take on the form of the dead person. An illusion, nothing else. Well, have fun.
What? You're not going either, Riku?
I keep my memories inside.
Huh?
Memories are nice, but that's all they are.
Orin can't go there, so... Spoilers.
What the?
The far plane was cool, but I couldn't stop thinking about Yuna. Her parents, they look so happy together. But it got me worried that maybe seeing them would make Yuna really consider Seymour's proposal.
Yo, Chapu! Meant to come see you earlier, yeah? Sorry. I know you won't hold it against me. I gave up the game. I'm a guardian from here on, you know? This guy looks a lot like you. Showed up. Traveling with him, I thought maybe you were still alive somewhere, yeah? But then again, here you are on the far plane. Guess your place is here. So, how you been? Oh, that guy I just told you about? I gave him your sword. He likes it.
Huh?
Wow.
He is dead, and I am still alive. Coming here really makes that clear. I should focus more on what I have to do now.
What?
I'm not even sure what I'm saying.
Don't you mean that you should leave Chapu behind? I'm sure he was a great guy, but there'll be others.
That's a possibility.
How about Waka?
What, me? With Waka?
Yeah, you two get along great.
Getting along isn't enough. Not even close.
I couldn't have.
Oh, sorry. My mistake.
You'd do well to remember that. Knowing a bit about women might come in handy someday.
Yeah, I'll remember.
I won't be forgetting either. Goodbye, Chapu. You always said I looked grumpy. But those were the happiest days of my life.
So, Yuna?
I've decided.
Really? That's good.
I remember when I was only 7 years old in Bavel that day. My father had defeated Sin, and the whole town was out in the streets. Everyone was laughing. They all seemed so happy. If I defeated Sin, that would make everyone happy, wouldn't it? I must do what everyone wants, not just what I want.
Let's go back. You gotta tell Seymour.
Before that, call Sir Jet. Give it a try.
Huh?
Don't worry. He won't come.
Trying not to think about my old man made me think about him, of course.
See, told you.
He isn't here because he's not dead. He's Sin.
That means he's alive, you know.
What if my old man really is Sin? What would I say to Yuna? Heck, to everybody in Spira. Wait, why should I have to apologize for him anyway? I'd rather never see him again.
What makes you hate him so?
Everything he does just makes me mad.
It was his fault that me and my mother...
Mom? It's her.
She's very pretty.
But wait, no one ever performed the sending for her.
She must have accepted death while she was still alive.
Whoa there. That's my mother you're talking about.
Oh, I'm sorry.
It's okay. I think I just figured something out.
What?
Why I hate my old man.
See, so I told him what I thought of him right there.
What, really?
Of course.
I suppose, but...
Mommy!
Just a sec, dear.
Whenever my old man was around, my mother wouldn't even look at me. Maybe that's when I started to resent him, even hate him. When he left us, Mom just lost her energy.
Is she all right?
Why should you care?
If she dies, I wouldn't know what to do.
Don't say Mom is gonna die.
I apologize.
The old lady next door told me, when a lovebird dies, the one left behind, it just gives up living so it can join its mate. It was just like that. I hated my old man even more. But really, my old man...
Mommy!
Just a sec, dear.
Go to him. He'll cry if you don't.
Oh, man. I must sound so stupid.
I don't think so.
How embarrassing.
Well, need some more time.
No. I'm ready.
Did I miss something?
Thanks for waiting. I'll go give my answer to Maester Seymour.
Lord Jiskal!
Oh, Lord Jiskal!
He does not belong here.
Why?
Yuna, send him.
Lord Jiskal.
He is Lord Jiskal no more. Send him now.
Talk later. We leave now.
What was that just now? That really Lord Jiskal?
I don't understand how a man like Lord Jiskal can die.
I would think that he was sent once, but he stayed on Spira. Something, a powerful emotion, could have bound him to this world. Such things happen.
That's against the rules, isn't it?
It means he died an unclean death.
I will go meet with Maester Seymour.
Yuna! Jiskal is the Guado's problem, not yours.
What?
So, Lulu, what do you think about Yuna getting married?
As long as the pilgrimage continues, either way's fine.
That's it? What if she doesn't even like the guy? Is that okay?
People marry for many reasons.
What's that mean?
Sometimes marriage doesn't require love, you know? Defeat sin and bring joy to the people of Spira. Get married and bring joy to the people of Spira. For Yuna, they're just two ways down the same road. All you need is determination. If you have that, you don't need love.
I don't know. I just don't get it.
Guado potions good. Buy some before leaving.
More than a guado, at least. What do you say?
Thank you.
Oh, sorry, I was having a moment there, guys.
When we leave here, we have to go through the Thunder Plains next, you know?
Listen, if Yuna gets married, then I...
What? That again?
Yes. If she is to marry, I would want her to marry for love.
See?
But if Yuna said she wanted to marry the one she loves, I would have to object.
Huh? You're not making much sense.
I know.
We leave as soon as Yuna returns. I trust you'll be ready. We leave as soon as Yuna returns.
Guado potions.
For a while there, I was a little worried about what was gonna happen, yeah?
Lulu?
I've talked enough about that.
What?
I'm sorry, just forget about it.
Jeez, Grumpy.
You'll understand one of these days. I just don't want to give it words, not yet. I shouldn't have to say this, but don't fall in love with her. I see, but... You must keep your feelings inside until the pilgrimage is over.
My, was the Lady Summoner not with you?
No, she's at Seymour's place.
That's Maester Seymour, or Lord Seymour.
Oh, I'll be careful. Sorry.
That's all right. Oh, Maester Seymour left Guado Salam a short while ago.
You serious?
I believe he went to the temple in Makalania. Maester Seymour is also the high priest of that temple.
Whoa! I gotta tell the others!
Lord Jisco, please tell me. What can I do to help?
Yuna, let's go!
They say Seymour went to Makarena Temple.
Makalania Temple.
I?
What I don't get is, why would the Lord Maester head off without a peep to anyone?
Maybe he wasn't expecting Yuna's answer so soon.
Ah, that's probably it.
Yuna, what is it?
Oh, nothing.
You're a poor liar.
It's true, it's nothing. Come on, let's go.
Oh no! We're here!
How are we supposed to cross that?
See the lightning rod towers? The lightning is drawn to them, hopefully.
We head north, not too near and not too far from the
towers,
yeah?
Bro, I think there's an ultimate weapon here, and I think you gotta dodge lightning first.
I think I forgot something in Guado Salam.
Nice knowing you.
Okay, I'll go!
dragon. Taking my better not you, mother.
Take that.
I hate this place. It's about time to get streamed from Destiny. Ethan. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, that's where we conclude this episode of Final Fantasy X Thunderplanes. Alright, let me get a drink, and we will start up Session of Destiny. Solstice of Heroes, you know, Solstice. Yeah, we'll see. Stay tuned, ladies.